Are you one of the frightened? Do you have trouble sleeping at night? Do you find yourself tossing restlessly in bed? I wonder why. Perhaps you saw something during the waking day that troubled you. What was it, then? That strange man on the bus, or the curious manner of that woman in the drugstore? Or maybe your story is like the bizarre incident in the life of John Le Grew. John Le Grew was a bachelor, but not by choice. For 12 long years since the war, he'd supported his ailing mother and denied his own happiness. You see, his anemic salary at the watch factory had not permitted any thoughts of increasing the Le Grew household. But John had had something out of life. In 1944 in France, during the war, he had met Denise Francon, the wonderful little French girl who had been the only love of John's shallow life. But a bombardment of her little village and the silence that followed had left John with only one conclusion. Denise was dead. Well, the war ended and he had returned to America and his mother and the watch factory. And the dull years had ticked away with the clocks. But one day, everything changed. John came home after a day at the factory and his mother said that a girl named Denise had called and wanted to talk to him. John couldn't believe his ears. There must be some mistake. Denise was dead. She had to be. But no. During dinner, the telephone in the hallway rang again. John rushed to answer it. It was impossible. It was unbelievable. But the sweet voice on the other end of the line was the same broken English of Denise Francon. And a dozen questions spilled from his heart. Where was she? How had she been? Why had she waited all these years to get in touch with him? Did she still love him? But oddly, Denise couldn't say much. Her voice seemed faint and shaky. But she gave out a telephone number. Butterfield 8-7777, and insisted that John should call her at that number at midnight. All the rest of the evening, John was in a fever of impatience. The tiny clock in the bureau mocked him as the hour and minute hands slowly crawled round to the appointed hour. Finally, it was midnight, and John lifted the phone from the hook and dialed the number. A male voice asked who was calling. Surprised, John wanted to know if he had the right number. Yes, it was Butterfield 8-7777. Whom did he want to speak to? John asked for Denise Francon. The voice seemed puzzled. I'm sorry, I don't seem to recognize the name. John's voice trembled. I'm sorry, he said, but this number was given to me to call at midnight and... The man's voice interrupted him, saying, "Oh, of course, I beg your pardon. Denise Francon? Yes, certainly, I remember now. The body was delivered for embalming yesterday morning. Looks like an automobile accident, and yet, well, in the midst of life, we are in death." John Le Grew hung up and sat in his chair, staring at the wall for a long, long time. And to this day, he still sits staring at a wall and hears a voice, a soft, sweet, trembling voice asking him to call and call and call. Well, I leave you. This is Woodlawn. What? Oh, I thought you knew. The Woodlawn Cemetery is my destination. You see, I live here. Goodbye for a while, and do call me when you get a chance.